Well, guess who? It's Allison and Maggie again.
Your favorite
talk show hosts. What have you got in store for us today, Allison?
Maggie's garage sale special.
Actually,
yard sale special.
The flashcards I got were from the garage sale, but this was I got new.
Oh,
it's new. These are.
Can you hold it up to the
call?
Tell me. Now let's see.
Let's camera. See.
Can you see it? Ah, tell me.
It says.
Tell me.
That little pink circle says, okay. As seen on the Oprah magazine.
Okay. So I pulled a card out.
Yes, you did.
This is how you get to know Maggie.
Do I get to read it? Or are you going to read it to me?
I'm going to read it to you, and you have to answer, Maggie.
First thing that comes to my mind, or
yes,
should I think
first thing that comes to your mind. What world event stands out in your memory?
World event. Does that mean
world event?
It can't have just happened in the United States?
A big event, something
affect
that
the
was
whole world.
Noteworthy, and everybody all around the world was paying attention.
Now, the first thing that comes to my mind, Allison, when you read that is the assassination of John F. Kennedy. Because I was, I think everybody back then, I don't know if you go that far back, Allison.
I do.
Usually remembers exactly what they were doing when they got that news. So I was in the ninth grade. I was in fifth period study hall at John Marshall High School. And they announced it over the PA system. It was a big auditorium study hall. And there was, I don't think we had a big TV screen to show it on back then.
No.
But they did keep putting the news on.
Radio.
In the radio, yeah. And the thing was, it was very sad because, I don't know, do you recall, everybody thought he was, well, we thought he was such a cute president and he was so charming and so nice. And it was the first, you know, after Eisenhower, it was just neat to have such a personable, young-looking president compared to what we had before, you know. anyways, I couldn't properly mourn because I had a Latin test coming up at sixth period, and I couldn't find anyone to tell me whether they might cancel that class or not. So everybody was talking, reminiscing, crying and everything, calling their parents, and I was studying my Latin because I couldn't be sure they weren't going to have that test. Well, it's just, this is a strange memory, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, I was a little younger than you.
Yep.
I didn't know anything that had happened.
And what grade were you in?
I did not know anything had happened until we got on the school bus to come home. And the big kids told the little kids that the president had been shot, and that the teachers hadn't told the little kids because we were too little, and they'd only told the 5th and 6th graders. So the 5th and 6th graders were lording over all of us.
Oh, what a way to find
out. And I was a 1st grader, so obviously they were lording over us and saying, you know, we know and you didn't know. And I really didn't quite comprehend, you know, what assassination was. I just know that they said the president was shot. Now when I got home, my mom, who was a stay-at-home mom, God bless her, was really upset. And I can guarantee you it was a memorable evening because she spent the whole evening sitting on the stool in the kitchen crying. And I don't think we really ever got dinner. She was just too distraught to prepare. So I'm sure we ate something eventually, but I mean, she was just very distraught. And I remember my dad coming home from work and trying to get her to pour ourselves together. So we can eat dinner, which is terrible, but you know, eventually, you know, the family does need to eat.
Oh, but it's kind of a uniting memory for everybody, what they were doing that day. And then other things that happened that day, we don't have any recall of them.
Oh, no.
No. Mm-hmm. Thank you for telling me that. What grade did you say you were in?
That's first grade.
First grade. I was in ninth grade. Okay. Well, stay tuned for our next adventure.